Dear students, hello and welcome to our non-technical project seminar. My name is Matthias Magdowski. I'm associated with the chair for electromagnetic compatibility at the Institute for Medical Engineering, and you can contact me via this email address. Before I will give you some more details about our seminar, I would like to start with a short motivation. At the end of your master course, your master study in Magdeburg, you will have to write a master thesis, a degree thesis, and you have all done your bachelor degree with a bachelor thesis at different universities in different home countries with different educational systems and background, and you all have different standards in how to write such reports and such thesis, and we would like to adopt you all to the same high standard that we have here in Germany. And in the recent years we found out that it's a lot of effort for every supervisor to teach every student about the fundamentals of scientific writing and working, and that's why we have invented this seminar. And why it's called a non-technical seminar or non-technical project seminar, I will tell you later. Another motivation why we offer this seminar is that we sometimes had the problems in the past with plagiarism, that students copied external text parts into their reports and theses, and we check all reports and theses with some electronic plagiarism checker, and this is then how such a typical result looks like. Everything that is marked here in colors is something that has been found by this tool as plagiarism, that has been copied as external text, verbatim external text from external sources without properly citing these sources, and this is what is not accepted here. And students who do this usually fail their thesis and sometimes maybe also fail their whole study, and this is what we want to avoid. That's why we want to make you very well aware of this problem of plagiarism. This is also a goal of this seminar. So after this short motivation, I will introduce you to our Moodle course and give you explain you the brief structure of our seminar. I will tell you a little bit more details about our lectures, and at the end of the seminar, to prove what you have learned, you will need to write a short paper and you will give a short presentation, and I will also tell you some more details about this later. So the Moodle course is used to collect all the materials, and we also use this as a communication forum. You can find it under this link, or you can also scan this QR code with your smartphone or cell phone. I will also paste this link into the comments below the video. And the whole or the seminar is embedded into a larger non-technical project. You get 5 ECTS credit points for this project, and the project at first consists of the seminar. The seminar runs over the first 6 weeks of the semester, so in the first 4 weeks we have these lectures, and after the lectures you will write your short paper and review it each other, and then there will be these short presentations, and after successful completion of the seminar you get a certificate. And then after the seminar, you will write a real project or deal with a real project report. This is also usually more technical. And the time that you have to complete this project is 8 weeks. And therefore, you have the last 8 weeks of the semester. And usually at the end of the project, you also give a presentation, and then you have completed the overall non-technical project, or sometimes it's just called project. Okay, so the seminar consists of 4 lectures. In the first week, there will be a lecture about scientific writing and working in general. It will be offered by Mrs. Kasper. Then in the second week, there will be a lecture about literature survey and reference management, and also about plagiarism and how to avoid it. This lecture will be given by Mr. Raya. Then in the third week, there will be a lecture given by me about visualization and how to draw a proper diagram and schematic and plots and so on. And last but not least, in the fourth week, Mr. Panicke will give a lecture about how to give a good talk, how to give a good presentation. All these lectures will be provided as video recordings. And yeah, to give you the possibility to ask questions and to have a short discussion about the content of the lectures, we will offer you a forum or text chat in our e-learning system. Okay, so after these lectures, or during the lectures, you will already get three topics sent to you via email for the short paper. And from these three topics, you select one. And these topics are usually non-technical topics. So one example is, why is so much tomato juice drunk on airplanes? Or has Coca-Cola really invented Santa Claus? Something like this. Why is Snow White? Why does the apple fall from the tree? So really, really non-technical topics, because the idea is that you should more learn how to structure a paper, how to structure a report, how to format it, how to use text editing systems, how to insert figures, how to cite sources, and so on and so on. And this is what you can also learn with a non-technical topic, without the burden to really have to think about some technical details in the background. And so you write short paper, just one full page, and this paper should be formatted according to a given template, and the template that we provide is the template by the IEEE, by the Institute of Electric and Electronics Engineers, and this is the quasi standard template for all publications in the field of electric engineering and also other engineering sciences. And this paper should include, as a paper usually should include, some abstract and some keywords, an introduction, at least one main section, a summary, and one or two or three references. And inside the main section, there should be at least also one figure or one table. Yeah, and then these short papers will be submitted to by you in the fifth week of our seminar. There will be some online submission. We will announce the exact dates via the e-learning system, and you will submit your paper as some electronic version as a PDF file. And then you will review the papers each other. So each of you will get three papers from your fellow students, from your peers, and you will get a corresponding evaluation sheet. And we will also explain how to evaluate these papers each other according to this given score sheet. And you will do this review over the weekend. And then in the sixth week, at the beginning of the sixth week, you return the results of these peer review, double blind anonymous peer review. You won't know which papers from which authors, from which of your fellow students you will review, and you will also not know from which of your fellow students your paper will be reviewed. And after this, you will also give short presentations about the very same topic as for your paper. The durations of this presentation should be 5 minutes, something like plus minus 1 minute. And also the slides should be formatted according to a given template. And this template will be like this template here, the standard template for presentations of our university. And for the presentations or for the talks of your topic, for the short presentations, we will split you up in groups of about 8 students, maybe a little less if we can do this, and 2 supervisors, and you will give your presentations. There will be a few questions and a short discussion, and also your presentations will be evaluated according to a given score sheet, and you will directly receive some feedback about your presentation and about your performance. And this will be done in the sixth week of the semester. Again, the details will be announced via our e-learning system, and we will do these presentations via a video conference system. And to prepare for this, you should please prepare slides and submit these slides as a PDF file into our e-learning system. Again, we will provide you with details how to do this. And then for the presentation, it would be good if you have a personal computer or notebook. And if you have a web camera with a microphone, or if you have a headset, and you should have broadband internet access so that you are able to attend to a video conference. To conclude, I would like to show you some student feedback. I will not read this, you can read this yourself, that we have received. So this is some example that we usually evaluate the seminar each semester, each year, and also ask the students for feedback about our seminar. And we also try to further develop our seminar. This is some feedback that we have received, and usually the students evaluate our seminar very well and say that they have learned lots of very interesting and very helpful information that is very interesting for them to complete their study and to write their master thesis and also later on maybe research papers. Okay, so this concludes this short introduction. If you have questions, write them here below in the comments, or write them via email to me, or write them into the forum of our e-learning course. Thank you.